Oh, be careful. Ah!
Thank you. I'm Greg Davies, and this is a brand new series of Taskmaster. The show is a well-oiled machine now, and I am your well-oiled host. Let me tell you, beneath this suit, I'm basted with the finest goose fat and ready to pop in the oven. Afterwards, take me out, and I'll melt in the mouth. Mmm, delicious. After the meal, what entertainment can I offer? Easy. I shall take five successful comedians and make them dance for you. Dance like they never thought it possible to dance until their hot tears fill their greedy little eyes. For they all long to take home this, a cheap mass-produced effigy of my head. Let the games commence. Please welcome Dara Ó Briain. Chawawa and Sarah Millican. And next to me, a man who recently confided in me when drunk that before bed each night, his wife puts talcum powder on his rear end and special area in what he described to me as his night-night bot-bot powder party.
Hey, Greg.
Hey, mate.
Finally, I've had the first draft of my new book.
OK.
You want to see it?
Yeah.
It's great.
OK.
It's, well, you know about it, obviously. It's the new autobiography of you. It's called Greg, A Force of Nature.
Thank you.
It's quite weighty. It's 700 pages. It's the first part of eight.
I like it.
Do you want me to read you an excerpt?
Read me an excerpt.
OK. Ooh. And then Greg Davies leapt off his horse and shouted, "That's how it's done, losers." And all the guys and girls watching him applauded and knelt down before him and they lay down before him and sort of curled up into balls before him, and Greg picked them up and rolled them at a barn and roared and roared at them.
And on we go. What's the first prize task category of this new series, my little furry friend?
Oh, today you've asked them to bring in the most jaw-dropping item. Ah, ouch. And the most jaw-dropping item of them all will get its owner 5 points and an early lead in the series. Ka-ching. Plus, at the end of the show, the winner will take home 5 jaw-dropping items and probably get lockjaw, Greg.
Right. Let's begin. Dara, what jaw-dropping item might you have bought us?
For me, jaw-dropping is defined by whenever you'd see Bugs Bunny or another beloved cartoon character dressed as a sexy female version of themselves. So I got this made.
It's certainly an old man, isn't it?
If you're not entirely sure about how jaw-dropping that is, you have to see the effect it had on Alex.
This is strong. Well played. Fern.
I brought in a framed picture of a rescue chicken called Fern Brady. Named after me, Fern Brady.
Here is a chicken called Fern Brady.
Yeah, there's this couple called David and Carol that really, really love comedy a lot, and they have rescue chickens named after different female comedians. I don't know if you've got one, Sarah.
It's a Sarah Millican chicken as well.
That's the thing, is they always update you on how your chicken is doing. So, like, Fern Brady the chicken was the biggest girl of the lot. She really enjoyed her food. But during the pandemic, when I'd lost all my work and I was feeling sad, I got a tweet from them one day saying, "Fern Brady died this morning, but she was doing what she loved best, eating breakfast out of David's hand."
That's pretty jaw-dropping.
OK.
These are strong so far. Someone's got to drop the ball soon, haven't they?
Well, it's John's turn now.
John, what have you brought in?
I brought in the Guinness World Records book.
This is going to take some talking round.
There's a tomato that's over £10, which is the size of a domestic cat.
It's a big tomato, he is right.
You've got a hairiest family.
They're the ones with hair over the
They're
face.
They're 98% hair.
They themselves are not 98% hair.
Is that the guy who was the quickest ever to get 1 point?
Sorry.
Munya, what have you brought in?
So I have brought in a knitted version of my head.
Here is his head.
What I like is that they've really nailed how that your teeth are on your lips. They've really caught that, yeah. Haven't they, in wool?
I don't own it. I had to buy it.
Oh. What? What?
Yeah, I had to buy it. £200.
No! What? It's awful. Sarah, can you beat that?
This is ceramic dildo. One of my jokes engraved. Is that the right word? I've never written on a dildo apart from mine.
I was told it was a ceramic bangle holder. Here it is.
Never put anything in your mouth you don't want.
Which
to.
Is the one bit of sex advice my mum ever gave me.
Yeah, it's genuinely quite shocking.
You've seen all five.
1 point to John.
1 point, OK.
I really loved it, but I'm only giving him 2 points. It's Munya's knitted head.
Oh, OK.
That's harsh.
Yeah,
that's
sorry, harsh. It is harsh, isn't it? Yeah.
2 points, OK.
I'm going to give joint honours to Dara's jaw-dropping cartoon and, incredibly, Sarah's ceramic dildo, because the thing that genuinely shocked me the most was that Fern would read, Fern Brady is dead. That's the thing that made my jaw drop.
OK, well, 5 points goes to Fern Brady.
There it is!
Here we go, then. What have we got first, Alex?
Well, we have a box-fresh task to kick off proceedings. Come in.
Oh, I've got a bit big-headed.
Come in to help you.
Yes, please, I really do.
I'm in.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. How you doing?
I'm good, thanks, Munya. Oh, hi, Fern.
Hi.
Hi, John.
Hello, Alex.
This way, please.
This way, please. Yeah.
Hello, Dara.
Hello, Alex. How are you?
So, yeah, face to front. You can take one step to me if you want. Oh, that's nice. And you can rotate this way a little bit if you want.
Yeah, cool. Let's look around.
And you can open the task. Would you like to read the task?
Yeah.
Am I reading it?
No, very happy to.
You can either post it in the top of my head or you could maybe read it for me.
Oh, I'd love to read it for you.
Yes, please.
You can hear the rustle of anticipation.
Right, Munya. What 10 films are you in? You have 15 minutes. Most correct films named wins.
What do you mean, what 10 films am I in?
Your time starts now.
What do you mean?
Most correct films
named wins.
That I am in.
Mm-hmm.
That I am in.
Yes.
They conducted themselves with absolute dignity, and I'm very excited to see them. And might I say, as a side note, Fern's early fury bodes very well for the rest of the series.
OK, here we go. It's Dara Ó Briain, John Kearns and Fern Brady.
Number one.
I'm trying to work out what film is that.
That is... Bowfinger?
Not far off.
What 10 films am I in? 7?
Yep, that's 1 out of 10.
What, did I just get one?
Yep.
Arrow, bow.
It's a sheep, bow peep. Ram, bow.
Rambo!
Correct.
Wizard.
Okay.
Boomerang.
So remember, it's a film.
Wizard.
Mm-hmm.
Boomerang.
I haven't seen that.
This is a bendy stick that comes back to you. What the hell's that called again? Oh, Australian, Not kangaroo. Stop saying kangaroo, my brain. It is a boomerang.
What the hell is that? Fucking elf wears that, but there's no elves in Australia.
Australian wizard. Oh, maybe another word for an Australian.
Yes.
Wizard of Oz.
Correct.
Jugs, jar, the three amigos. What the hell would be in this?
I don't know, the chipmunks.
Next one. I'm good at these. I like these games.
Crusty golf.
Cornflakes, golf club.
Yep.
Cornflake club. The breakfast club.
Correct.
Wow!
This was a club, something club.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Go on to the next one.
Okay.
So they're peas.
Okay. What's the movie?
Peas?
Oh, for Jesus' sake.
You've got 3.5 minutes.
Oh, my God, really?
Mm. Frozen peas. Frozen.
Correct.
This is an orange. Clockwork orange.
Correct.
I feel like this one's actually an easy one.
Yes.
But it's not coming to me.
Stones. Romancing stone.
I'm going to go with moon.
Moon. OK.
Top gun.
No.
Fan gun.
No.
Fanny. Fanny weapon.
It's not fanny weapon.
Oh. Gone with the wind.
Correct. Oh, you're looking for number 9?
Yeah.
OK, I'm number 9.
Well, those are carrots, right?
Yep. And then I've got things in my hands as well.
A tea bag?
OK.
Is it?
Yep, and one other thing here.
Carroty ginger.
But that's not ginger.
Oh, it's a horse.
Goat, tea bag, carrots. Carrot tea, ram.
Carroty goat. What the hell? Karate Kid.
Correct. You're number 10. You represent a moment in a film. You've got 30 seconds.
In total?
In total, yeah.
Oh, shite.
Yeah, no, it's gone badly.
It has gone badly, hasn't it?
Mm.
Yeah.
The time up, Dara.
I'm sure the expression on that box changed to great sadness.
It got sadder. That still photo got sadder and sadder as I couldn't remember the names of any film.
Dara, not the first comedian to do this show because his children enjoy it, only to lose all the respect his children previously had.
So he got 3 out of the 10 films.
John, when you just shouted at the top of your voice, chipmunks, it felt like a man throwing in the towel for the whole series. Fern, pleased with your performance?
Yeah, I think I did.
How many did Fern get? Let's just find out.
She got 60% of them right. 6 out of 10.
Really good. Really good. Nice. Mm. I thought that the Wizard of Oz, I thought your title was better.
What did I pick?
The Australian Wizard. 6 points, and John got 4 points?
Yes.
One film that you were adamant about was Peas, the film. And as it's not a real film, I wonder if you wanted to pitch it, maybe?
Peas, a lonely gardener during lockdown.
Yep.
The only thing that grows in his garden is peas.
Yep.
He goes to bed, the peas run in the house, and they kill him and then live his life.
That's Peas.
Coming to a cinema near you.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, that's the end of part one. Or for our French-speaking viewers, la bibliothèque, il est dans le jardin. Bonsoir, welcome back. And for our French-speaking viewers, Alex est un petit cheval. Where were we, Alex?
Merci pour les baguettes. Yes, our 5 contestants were in 10 films. Before the break, Dara, Fern and John worked out what a few of them were. But how will our final 2 do? Let's find out as Sarah Millican and Munya Chawawa investigate.
What the hell's this now? This is the bow and arrow. I know the feeling of this.
OK.
OK.
A ram?
OK.
Silence of the Rams?
Silence of the Rams. It's not Silence of the Rams.
Sheep. A ram. Rambo.
Correct.
Yes!
So it's a witch's hat, boomerang. Oh, such a puzzle.
Oh, the Wizard of Oz.
Correct.
Yes.
You're good at this, Munya.
Yeah, catch. No, I'm joking.
The Wizard of Oz returns?
Well, you sort of said it.
Well, give me the point then.
What's the film?
The Wizard of Oz.
Correct.
Oh, Australia. Oh, you dicks. Lovely, I'm having a great day.
One jar, two jar, three jar. Jar Wars.
Jaws?
Close.
Jaws.
Correct.
It's like a golf club with eczema.
Something club. Fight club.
No.
Breakfast club.
Correct.
Yeah.
Oh, peas?
Oh, man. Oh. Oh, it's peas.
Frozen.
Frozen. Correct.
Yes.
This is...
Clockwork Orange.
Clockwork Orange.
Correct.
The Rock.
Close.
The Rock 2.
Rock. Rocky.
Correct.
Is the word Rocky?
Correct.
Oh, God.
Was it a gun?
Yes.
Gundy?
It's not Gundy, no.
Gun with the Wind.
Oh, my word.
Is
correct.
It?
Yes.
Yes!
Gun with the Wind.
Correct.
Shut your face.
Form, bro. You're a bit older than a kid, but Karate Kid.
Correct.
Yes.
You are clue number 10.
I am?
Yes.
I'm not in any films. Sarah Millican. The Sarah Millican film.
Nope.
My head right now is in a box.
Yes.
That is the exact same as a moment in a film.
Yes.
Big heads, corner heads. Cardboard heads.
No. Do you want to blow the whistle or shall I?
Yeah, you blow the whistle.
I'm intrigued by Munya picked up a bow and said, I've written it down because I was so intrigued, I know the feeling of this.
So, in Zimbabwe, we used to have 9 gardeners, OK? Now, it's not because we're bougie, it's because that's just the done thing. So,
to
basically...
To have 9 gardeners. To,
yeah. My dad was like, look, I can't afford these 9 gardeners, too many, yeah? So, we need to rank them. So he put me in charge of ranking them. So what I would do is I would give them tasks. Like, I was a Zimbabwean taskmaster, and one of them was to make me a bow and arrow. So the person who made me the bow and arrow was top gardener, so...
What the fuck's going on?
It's worth you knowing that he will mention Zimbabwe in every single task.
Wow, amazing. Give me some scores.
Well, I can tell you Sarah got 7 out of 10. Munya, 8 out of 10. So which means Munya gets 5 points, 4 to Sarah, 3 to Fern, 2 to John, Dara just the single point.
Dara, you're pretty angry about this, yeah?
Not at you, not at the show, not at the concept, not at the whole idea of puzzles and fun. I'm just angry at me.
And we're only in the first task proper.
Yes.
Which means that John is last place by quite some distance, but in joint first we have Fern and Sarah with 8 points.
Let's see another task, please.
OK, then, Greg, it's our first location task of the series, and this time, for a bit of a laugh, we borrowed the whole of Gatwick Airport's South Terminal. Good stuff. Lou, roll VT.
Hello, Alex.
Hi, Fern.
Hey.
Imagine if I just knocked this over there. That'd be funny, wouldn't it?
Oh, I love a toilet roll. I feel much happier now that there's loads of toilet rolls here.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to love this.
Land loo roll in the loo.
You must stay on the spot at all times.
Most loo roll in the loo wins.
You have 15 minutes, your time starts now. That's not an easy shot.
Well, in my real life, I'm actually amazing at this. I'm always knocking full toilet rolls into the toilet.
What happens when I run out?
You'll either be happy or sad.
You know, in Zimbabwe, I'm used to long drops. So this should be a doozy. Or a loozy.
Do you genuinely knock full toilet rolls into the toilet regularly?
Yeah, I get it.
So do I.
For it.
It's so upsetting. I've got a massive mirror in my bathroom. And I would say once a week I do that and then look at myself and go, you fat arsehole. Let's play.
OK, first use the toilet. It's Dara and Fern.
Ooh.
OK, I'll just try one just to try one, OK? No.
How long have I got? 15 minutes.
You've got 15 minutes.
Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, no!
Can roll it down something.
Wadding it?
Drainage pipe anywhere.
Oh, no!
String? Wire?
Do you think I should have a tactic?
I don't know.
Just... Oh! Did that count?
No.
Obviously, I could do it in smaller chunks and get something in here. That wasn't one of them.
Sort of counted that one.
Is there an ideal amount of weight to stability?
Yes! Yes!
Can we break into a fishing supply store?
Right. Over?
You've got 13 minutes left.
You're directing this. OK, I'm off the mark.
I think you finished early. Well done.
Thank you.
Congratulations. 1 out of 12 winning.
You weren't expecting the second one to land, were you? Hit the rim 6 times in a row. That's shattering.
Incredible to watch Dara ruminating to himself all of the many ways he could do this. And I wrote down, my impression was that Dara was walking the fine line between physics theorist and confused uncle in a shed. But he landed a couple of sweet ones in the pan, right?
Yes, he got a whole roll in, which is 140 sheets, we all know that, and 43 other individual sheets. I do have to go through the toilet at the end of this task and count them, which
That was the only pleasure left open to me, is the thought of you going through my toilet paper and individually counting the sheets.
That must have given you a little lift after all of the rim shots, which were, and I quote, shattering. Fern had a less technical system. It seemed to me that you thought, yeah, I'm just going to chuck all these one by one and after each one I'm going to go, oh, no.
Yeah, and I didn't realise till you said there was 13 minutes left. That was when I realised I might have done it differently to everyone else. Yeah.
Who's next?
Next up to throw down are Munya and Millican.
Part of me thinks it's just throwing and hoping it hits.
If I break these into pieces, I could basically have 100 shots. Oh!
It does have to go in the loo.
Yeah, I know that. We've all missed the seat a few times in our life, haven't we? There you go.
I'm just going to start. That's quite close. Maybe this isn't impossible.
Oh! Just keep it going. LeBron James. LeBron James.
Maybe here. No, too far.
LeBron James. LeBron James. Ready for this? LeBron James.
No. Oh, I flushed it though.
That's just over half your loo rolls gone.
It feels silly to just chuck 5 more.
LeBron James. LeBron James.
Oh! Could I get some water? Oh, thank you. I can't get off my spot.
No, you can't.
Stick to the rules. Thank you. Just wet them to make them a bit heavier.
Yeah.
Does it count?
Stupid game, anyway.
This is so satisfying.
I can't believe I missed this many. This is impossible.
The ones with the little tails do look amazing when they go.
Yeah, well, it's not about your artistic direction, is it? Right. It's about getting them in.
No.
How long? No! No! Yes!
10 seconds. And this is the final bit of loo roll, is it?
Yeah.
Good luck! No! It's pretty good.
Whatever, Alex.
Munya, at the beginning, what did you mean when you said we've all missed the seat sometimes?
Listen, we all have a pass.
You poo off the seat?
Not me personally, just, you know, when you've got 9 gardeners, a lot of stuff happens.
Fascinating. Sarah, you stopped halfway through to try a new system.
Yeah.
And it was a delight.
Oh.
Make the paper heavy.
Yeah.
Make it more like a poo.
Not like mine.
Oh, no?
No. That's too solid for me.
Is it?
Yeah.
Just a disaster zone, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I'll be honest with you, Sarah, mine's not pretty. But I thought it was a masterstroke.
I don't know that it worked. Oh, did it?
You did actually say, I've never seen a kingfisher. I imagine this is what it's like.
Swack.
Yeah.
How many of her big, wet kingfishers went in?
She had a total of 80 individual sheets, whereas Munya, just 61.
Good. Break. Welcome back to the very third part of the very first episode of the very 14th series.
Oh, what a wacky intro. Before the break, the new lot had got through security at Gatwick South so that they could throw loo rolls from a height into a toilet. We've seen everyone apart from John Kearns. So here is John Kearns.
With ever anything like this, I don't need power. Gravity will provide the power. So, weirdly, I'm going to throw it up before I throw it down. Right, I might try throwing it down now. Well, I'm just gonna have another go. Right.
That was really quite a long way away from the toilet.
Ooh, got an idea. Make a little paper airplane. Well, look how beautiful it is first and foremost. The chassis, the wings. It's a fantastic piece of engineering. Fly, my pretty. Fly. Oh, God. Right, hang on.
What's happening now?
I'm going to make a bigger one.
A bigger one? Yeah.
Right, I need to rethink this now.
It'd be great to get some loo roll on the loo.
Yeah, I know that. That's the task. So I'm here. Too high up.
20 seconds, John.
Well, I'll release that. Well, that didn't go to plan.
I had such high hopes because of the archway you delivered the sentence, gravity will provide the power. I thought this man knows what he's talking about.
Yeah, I do.
No, you don't. I tell you, it's a shame we don't give Art House points, though.
Oh, man, that is... I mean, he may not win this game, but he'll win a César, the French Oscars for Best Short Film.
That's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
From the maker of peas.
It's frustrating to watch, though, for John, because he is an amazing shot. Afterwards, we sometimes stick around and have a bit of fun. John grabbed a loo roll, chucked it straight in.
Have you got it?
No, I didn't film it. Yeah, we did. Watch it.
Oh!
That, I don't know.
That's got to just be gut-wrenching, isn't it? Hey, let's have some points.
Right, well, John didn't get any in. Does he still get a point, Greg, for coming
last?
Yeah,
for God's sake. For the sheer beauty, he's got to get a point.
Single point to John. Then we have Munya with 2 points. Sarah came third, 3 points. Fern, 4 points for second place. But the winner with 5 points is Dara Ó Briain. Oh,
wow. 183 sheets. The master physicist strikes. Time for one more.
You bet, with Matthew Kelly, and it's the first team task now.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello, Fern. Please wait.
Hi, Alex.
Hi, Sarah.
I don't know what you've got. A length of drain pipe.
Yeah.
I don't like your little geeky socks.
You don't?
No.
I don't like this. It looks like I might have to do a forward roll or something.
Can you do a forward roll?
For you, I'd give it a go.
Great.
Should I read the task? Hi. Oh, hello.
Hiya.
Hey, Fern, how are you?
All right.
You are now a team.
Oh, damn. OK.
Dara, this is Fern. Fern, this is Dara.
Hey, nice to
meet
you.
Hi, lovely to meet you.
You are a team.
Oh.
Oh, cool.
Cool.
Yeah? You can stand next to each other if you want.
Oh, sorry, I thought there was a thing.
No, you just... Wherever you want, really.
Good, thanks.
Then.
Well, I want to do...
There's John!
Uh-huh.
Should I...
You go ahead, please.
Good luck, team.
Create the best picture of a bird on the black square.
You may not step on or do anything to the black square.
Alex will walk towards you every time you name a different bird.
Alex will stop moving every time you name a different fish. Oh, my God!
I hear that. This is sick. OK, all right.
You have a maximum of 15 minutes. Your time starts when Alex withdraws his nail.
So is there paint?
Wait. Paint is going to start spraying out as soon as he pulls out that nail.
So if I said a bird's name, you would walk towards me?
I will follow the last person who said a species of bird.
But if we name a fish...
He stops.
He stops when we name
a
fish.
How good are you on fish and birds?
That was my uni degree, so we're all good.
Was it your uni degree?
Yeah, I mean, some people call it psychology, but I...
Very nice. Degree or not, my gut instinct is it's going to go very badly for both teams.
Oh, OK.
I could be wrong. And my only other observation is that during that, Fern was either freezing or needed a wee.
it was both. It was really hard to go to the toilet in that costume.
Yeah.
So I think I went once in the whole series.
Excellent.
OK, well, luckily, nobody's going to have to imagine a world without montages because we've got one right here. OK, I'm now going to withdraw my nail. Good luck, everyone.
All right. Oh.
Oh, no.
OK, we're losing paint quickly here.
Yeah, OK.
OK, Alex. Pigeon.
Carp. Stop.
There we go. I'd say...
Magpie.
OK.
Fish.
Seagull.
Alex, seagull, sea bream.
Oh, will you just keep coming towards me?
Until you say a fish.
Carp. Right, okay.
Eagle. Goldfish.
What? Jesus, what type of bird? Owl.
I can't think of a fish. Tell me a fish.
Owl, pipe, blowfish.
Where's the head? Is that the head up
there?
That's
the head up there.
Pork. Angelfish.
You did do your degree in this.
I'm telling you.
This is a bird that's been run over. What? Beak. That's its beak.
Shouldn't we put a foot over here?
Why was your foot sticking out of its arse?
Could it be a bird at any other angle?
We could start again. I'm totally not seeing how you don't see this.
Okay, it looks like a mangled rabbit or something.
I can't think of any birds or fish.
Falcon.
Falcon.
No! Quick, say something.
Different bird. Nuthatch.
That's the head, yeah?
Yes.
So what's this? The body?
It's a body. Yeah. It's a turkey.
Oh, yeah. I think our problem is that we can't remember at critical times the names of birds or
fish.
So get maybe 3 birds and 3 fish.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Badger. Badger. 3 of them.
Badger. Is an eel a fish or a snake? We need an eye, but how do
we know, an eye? I know. If one of us is above Alex, then he has to lift the paint up, which means it stops pouring. Do you see what I'm saying?
How are you going to get above him?
Mexican parrot. Hey, look, I'm up, I'm up.
Oh, yes, you are.
We very much lost the bird.
He doesn't look like anything.
There's so much wrong with this.
Where's the head now?
You've got the beak, you've got the foot, you've got the tail, you've got the wing. Now we've got a bird.
2.5 minutes.
Penguin is a penguin. It's a penguin. It's a bird.
Come on, this could maybe be a bird.
That's not a bird.
I have to know when to step away. Let's step away. Fancy a cuppa, Sarah?
Let's have a cuppa. Good plan.
Look at that. That's a, look at the beak. Look at the beak there.
Right.
Like a goose.
Are they going in?
They've gone in there. Like...
Okay. As I predicted. The group of three, to me, seemed to be the least organised, although Dara took an early leading role.
Yeah, much ignored.
You did, for the first few minutes, run round and round the canvas and then say to Alex really aggressively, what, you're just going to keep coming towards me? It put me in mind of a documentary about how six-year-olds interact. What about the group of two? There was a better dynamic there, I thought.
Yeah, we are pretty much an interracial JLS, so I felt like we...
Do you mind if I write that down?
Please do, yeah, no, please. I thought we had an exceptional use of physics. You know, a wise man once said, gravity will do the rest. So, yeah. I feel like we did pretty good.
You remember it differently to me.
You're going to have to wait until after the ads to see the birds they've created. It's our way of teasing you back in case Sarah Millican's bangle holder wasn't doing the job. See you soon. The final part of the show and the conclusion of our first team task of the series.
Yes, they were directing me to draw a picture of a bird. I was steadily leaking paint out of a hole and they were shouting fishes and birds at me at the same time. You get the idea. Best picture of a bird wins. So, this is what Munya and Sarah created.
That does look like a bird. See?
It starts a shock and then it gets impressed.
It looks like it's leaning into wind.
It's a bird with human feet leaning into the wind.
Well, you know, that's evolution.
Yeah. I thought it was one of her kingfishers. I've kind of brought it to life.
Yes.
Fabulous kingfisher. The majestic.
That's a Zimbabwean nuthatch.
I thought it might be, yeah.
Very rare, very rare, extremely rare.
OK, well, would you like to see what the team of three ended up with?
Let's see this beautiful bird.
There we go. There's the bird.
Yeah. You can see the beak here at the left-hand side. The wings are up like this around it, and that's the body of it at the back there.
Exactly the same tone of voice Dara used when he was running around going, oh, yeah, right, you're following me now, are you? John? Fern?
No, I mean, it don't, unless the bird's been exploded everywhere, it doesn't look like anything.
Look, there were differences of vision within the team.
They went for a bird.
Oh, this is, do you not see the duck's head?
I can see a bird. Also, the right-hand side is a head.
No!
It is, it's a chicken, look. Here we go.
What the...
standard chicken. We can see the chicken in action. There we go.
You criticised our feet. How dare you?
It's pointing the other way.
Thanks for confirming there's no bird in there.
Well, you've got to judge them. Which is the better bird?
Don't be so ridiculous. Right. We know what the better bird is. It's just how we divide the points. But, you know, let's not pretend that that bird's good. I feel sorry for them, so I'm going to give them 2 points for their mass of lines.
The team of three.
That's correct.
OK.
But I'll be giving 5 points, the top marks, to the team of two.
There we go. 5 points to Munya and Sarah. quick look at the scores.
Right, well, he's still in last place with 6, and the leader now has 10 points more than that. It's Sarah with 16.
OK, everyone, please make your way to the stage for the final task of the show. That look on Dara's face, I call it deep regret. Munya's got his on at a jaunty angle look.
Of course he has. Yeah, that's how they wear them in Zimbabwe.
He's going to read the task out.
Fern Brady is going to.
Good luck, Fern.
Get the most weight on the seesaw without popping the balloon. Taking it in turns, you must place a single item of your additional clothing in the triangular basket. The most weight in the triangular basket when the balloon pops wins. But if you pop the balloon, you get 0 points.
So one at a time, they're going to pop one of the additional clothing items in the triangular basket. They're trying to put the most weight in there before the balloon pops. So we know how much each of your items weighs. What you don't want to do is pop the balloon.
Oh, yeah, because you get nothing then.
So we're going to start with the person in last place, good. Greg, and that's obviously John.
I'm going to go with the top hat.
Oh, he's going big. You can turn this round.
No, no, he's 10 points behind
Sarah.
No,
I know.
All right, here we go.
Oh, perfect.
Right.
Wow, that delivery was almost arrogant.
Next, it's Dara Ó Briain.
Good luck, Dara. Ooh, yeah, he wouldn't go with a boot.
Yeah.
Gently. Oh, big but gentle. Oh, you lovely bear. Well played.
In third place, it's Munya, Chawawa. Another boot.
Let's see what I'm going to do.
LeBron James.
LeBron James.
Double boot.
There we go.
No movement yet. It's Fern Brady to go next. Another boot.
Oh.
Yeah, come on, Fern. That's
oh,
it.
Fern. Oh, easy. Easy.
Sarah Millican, the current leader. Is she going boot?
Oh, God. She'd be mad to. Yeah, better.
Yeah, there we go.
Very clever.
Lovely. One item, it's back to you, John.
Well, another boot, I think.
Another boot?
Yeah.
I'm absolutely pissed on the adrenaline there. Oof.
Still really gonna move.
There's slight movement there. Back to Dara. He's going flipper. I think he's using physics. Munya, you're up, Munya.
Cool. I'm going to go glove because it's really irritating my eczema.
Lovely delivery.
LeBron James.
Fern, you're up.
That's it.
Lovely. Going flipper.
In it goes. Lovely.
Sarah, you're up. She's not.
Oh, hello.
Oh, she wouldn't.
Oh, hello.
She wouldn't. Oh, it's madness.
Yeah, nothing's happened yet. Right, it's it's John again.
And I think it needs a bit of
force. No, you don't want to pop the balloon, John.
No, but I don't think I'll do it enough.
You do you, John. You play your game. Oh!
Right.
Now we're getting somewhere.
Dara Ó Briain next.
Good morning, Mr. Scrooge.
Oh, he's got. Yeah, I see what
you're lovely.
Doing.
Are we happy that's in the triangular basket?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, all right. It has got invisible.
Physics, yes. Oh.
Okay, Munya.
Okay, you know the thing they're going to say about Munya? He lives on the edge.
I don't think that's what they're going to say. Oh, lovely. Oh, Munya.
Can you help balance me? Just hold my hand.
No.
No, please.
No, quite right, John. Fuck it.
Hold my hand, please.
Why?
Because I need the balance, because the more weight my nails put
I'm
on
in
it,
last
the
place.
More... It doesn't matter, bro. You've got nothing to lose. OK, bro, count me down from three. Count me down from three!
Three, two, one.
Join me down here.
Well, well, well.
But that's put the cat amongst the pigeons, hasn't it?
So, obviously, Munya, who was too near the edge in the end, gets 0 points. Sarah put 1,071 grams in. Fern, 1,310 grams. Dara and John, both exactly the same, 1,461. Which means that Sarah gets the 2 points, 3 points to Fern, but in joint first place, 5 points to Dara and John. Shall I tell you what the final scores are?
Yes, please.
Well, there's only 1 point separating three people, but the winner with 18 points is Sarah Millican.
Sarah wins. Please head up to the stage to enjoy your jaw-dropping prizes. A new series has begun. See you next time. But for now, well done again to our first winner, Sarah Millican.
Our Greg wasn't always in charge, you know. Stream all episodes of his not-so-powerful days in Man Down Now on All 4. 10 p.m. next Thursday back here, John Richardson's road tripping across Spain with purpose in a brand new one-off, Take My Mother-in-Law. How kind. Brand new Naked Attractions up next.